You know, Kmele, I was when I was watching that, I it's like, whatever happened to fair fights? Like, if they were like, if they each one paired off, I would be okay with that. But there was 3-on-1 here. Four, you know, it was like a lot of people kicking people when they're down.
Yeah.
You don't ever do that.
No. I only do that anonymously on
I didn't
blogs.
Know if you were doing a thing when you said fair fights. Yeah. See what I did there? Mm-hmm. I cannot imagine. Actually, let me start here. Mm-hmm. The very best thing about the pandemic, to the extent there can be a best thing about it, was that the airports were completely empty. And
yeah.
I had all of these opportunities to ride on planes, fly in first class, of course, never coach because people like that are the ones in coach causing trouble.
Yeah.
But I had all these opportunities to fly on the plane by myself,
yeah.
only me.
Yeah.
And now we're getting back to normal and there are complete utter brawls, chaos
yeah.
in the standby line.
Well, but yeah. no, but the restaurants are still only at 50% capacity, so there's nothing to do, so they got to do this, people got to do this.
So this is what we have to look forward to.
Yeah, what a low standard for
all
behavior,
All I'm saying
Kat.
Is that guy...
Typical libertarian.
All I'm saying is that that guy that did get beat up, he decided not to press charges. He's probably like, that punch hurt, but
and
I
no
feel
one
alive
wants to press
again.
It's the weirdest thing.
This is a guy who is an independent thinker who's kind of quirky, mm-hmm. but he's got to go. Just for that, he's got to be he has to believe everything they believe.
Yeah, well, Elon is among the only like super duper wealthy people who actually, when you hear him talk, you imagine this is what he really means because
yeah.
he actually says the things that he means in most instances. But I'm also wondering about like SNL, which has not been funny for a very long time. Elon doesn't strike me as a guy with a tremendous amount of comedic timing. I don't
yeah.
know that he's gonna bring the whole quality of the show up very high, although the show hasn't been funny in some time.
Yeah, speaking of funny, can I ask you a question? Why do you have yeah. an extra pair of shoes?
I couldn't decide which shoes to wear. So I have the Yeezys, but we could go with the whites. Maybe I'll switch at some point.
You didn't want to wear the white shoes, did you?
I mean, do you want me to put the white shoes on?
Because we're angry white males.
Well,
especially me.
I don't
yes.
believe in race. I don't practice that nonsense. I wear
this
whatever
is a
shoes
first. A first, somebody brings an extra pair of shoes as if like there might be a mud puddle on the set.
Yeah. It's entirely possible. One never knows what they'll encounter.
That is true, yeah. especially on this show. I tend to have accidents now and again. Kat, you're no accident. I don't even know what that means. It was just a segue.
I don't think I was because I was the oldest.
If you ever came to me and said to me, I don't want that guest on the show because I disagree with his beliefs, what do you think I would say?
We would never have any guests on the show. We would never.
Yeah.
Because I like think for myself about things, right? Like, I don't agree with everything that Mike Pence believes.
Mm-hmm.
And I know that because I was able to listen to and read them.
Yes.
And form an opinion, which is a valuable thing. He's also a former vice president. He's not just like some random bridge troll. Like, not that I would not read that book because
yeah.
bridge troll life, fascinating.
Yeah.
But like a lot of people do agree with him.
Mm-hmm.
And you would want to understand that mm-hmm. and engage with that and be able to have more knowledge and not less about an entire period in history.
Mm-hmm.
And to have this view that your view is not just like the only, you know, view that is desirable for people to consume, but acceptable to people to consume is arrogant,
mm-hmm.
and thinking that makes you a good person is also delusional.
Yeah. Enough, Kmele. You did something interesting.
Yeah.
You left New York.
Yes.
At just about the right time, but then you moved to California.
It was a strange decision, right outside of San Francisco, of all places.
Yes. Yes. Yes.
Yeah.
How's the smell?
Well, you know, I'm in Tiburon,
yes.
which is, you know, across the
yeah.
bay there and is lovely.
Mm-hmm.
Marin County is beautiful. The only problem I have is a lot of my neighbors, they just lurch at the opportunity to talk to me,
ugh.
To express their allyship, to tell me how much they care and how important I am and how much my life matters. It's a little bit overwhelming.
You want to be ignored like you were in New York.
It would be nice.
Yeah.
I've said before, like, there's something a bit Get Out-ish about, like, everywhere you turn, there's a sign that says, your life matters. We really care. You belong here. We want you to stay. You know what I mean? It's a little creepy. So.
Oh, my God. That is so funny. And true, Kat, you know, when the people flee and they go to these other states, should they be allowed to vote?
Yes.
All right, next question.
I mean, I don't think there's any way they can't.
Temporary ban, 5 years. Temporary voting ban so they don't ruin the state they move to.
Hmm.
Unless it's Kmele because he's just moving to California. Same thing from New York.
Yeah, I'm not really sure what the legal basis for a law like that would
there
be.
There is none.
Right, yeah. Exactly. That would be my concern. But, you know, sure, that look, I love the way that this was framed as like population shift, et cetera, not like people fleeing syringe and, you know, feces littered tyrannical wastelands. But remember,
that's your apartment.
Oh, yeah. Well,
I've been there.
Look, not since we got the cleaning lady. But but like, remember what everyone was saying over the summer? Oh, GOP people said everyone's going to flee New York and everyone's going to flee California. And it's this talking point. And it's like, well, no, it sucks here.
Yeah. Yeah. And so people are actually voting with their feet.
With their feet.
Yeah, take a minute before
we... What's wrong with the spaceship?
That's why it's more important to evaluate issues on a case-by-case basis rather than being in the situation where you have to idolize people that, oh, because they're in the same political party. And, mm-hmm. and you know, like, honestly, if you're saying, hey, I have a problem with this person has done things I think are wrong, you say, shut up, they're a leader on your side, you can't say that, that is a cult.
Yes, it is right. A cult.
Yeah, she seemed to be taking a swipe at partisanship more broadly.
Yeah.
I mean, even what she had to say about Republicans, I leave them alone because they tell me what they're about. That doesn't sound like a compliment at all. As someone who is very skeptical of most of the two major political parties, I can, some of those vibes resonate with me, but I also, Rob, have the same sort of skepticism. I see shades of Kanye there. Like, a lot of people got very enthusiastic when Kanye seemed to be gravitating towards their guy, Donald Trump. Like, Kanye also ended up running against him, right? Yeah. I don't know that it made much of a difference, but folks like this who have these kinds of changes of heart, I don't know that they're going to be very reliable political allies.
And I agree with you, Kmele, because I am an ally.
And it's appropriate for you
How
to
How are you? Are you,
thank you.
I feel seen. Matters.
Please.
I feel seen.
Thank you. I see you. I see you.